Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Oil of Myrrh and Sweet Perfumes. This is When Singles Pray, and we are here again to offer prayers as our custom is. Thank you all so much for joining yesterday. I had a wonderful time with my friend, Pastor Shehun Oshigbeson. She was on IG Live with me to discuss self-love redefined. So I want to encourage you to please find the video, especially for those of you watching on YouTube. Find the video on my IG page, the When Singles Pray IG page, and watch the session we had together. We talked about self-love and the deeper meaning of self-love, why many ladies get it wrong, because they actually do not think that their choices or the quality of their choices is a reflection of how much they care for themselves as well, how much they love themselves as well. We also talked about the 6 laws of a sex-free dating relationship. Number one, she said you need to find somebody who is also a believer in no premarital sex. Then number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, she said you need to be taught about it. You need to learn. You need to open up yourself to tutelage, right, on the subject matter. Excuse me. So Shane was with us, and she talked about all of these things. Please get the video on my IG Live and you can watch it, share it with other single ladies. But most importantly, please buy the book. The book is titled Dear Single Lady. So everything we discussed yesterday are snippets from the book. Please do well to buy the book. To the order of the day. Today is day 23. Today is day 23. I didn't want to think that inconsistency is about to set in. So I told myself, regardless of what time it is, I am going to come up here live today. And most likely, I will do day 23 and 24 together, because yesterday, Shane was around, right? So I had a recording yesterday, but I've archived it. I'm going to summarize the things that I said yesterday in today's episode, right? And then we'll do day 24 as well. I don't want us lagging, and I don't want inconsistency to set in. I had to quickly jump into this car even before the sun goes out. All right. So yesterday I came up to elaborate on the concept of the homemaker, why the single woman needs to start to emulate, right, and assimilate some of the traits and the portrait of the homemaker, what the homemaker really does, and how the concept of homemaker came into being. We talked about that. We talked about, you know, how the concept of career woman came into existence and what the homemaker ought to still do. And then sort of a redefinition of the homemaker now, because women have now been exposed. The need to survive has caused many women to become career women. And that is not bad in itself. It's just that Titus chapter 2 from verse 1 to 5, especially verse 5, makes us realize that the younger women must be taught to be keepers at home, KJV says homemakers. And people, some people believe that you cannot be keeper of a home you're not present in. You cannot be making a home that you're not present in. However, you still need to survive. Remember, we discussed a whole day, we spent a whole day discussing finance for the woman. What happens if the woman does not have a spouse? Right? Because women started becoming career women when World War One and World War Two rendered some men literally dead, or they couldn't fend for their families anymore as a result of injuries from the war. All right. So what if the woman does not have a spouse anymore? Would she still not make the home? And would she not still make ends meet? So these are questions that call for contemplation and deliberation. And at the end of the day, my own conclusion is the woman can still stay at home, right? The advent of civilization and democratization has made it possible that you can reach the world from your home. You can offer value from your home. So it all depends on how exposed you are, how informed you are, and your willingness to actually offer value to people out there. You can be so valuable to the point that people now will be interested in exchanging that value, right, for money in monetary terms. And so by so doing, you will be earning passive income, just like we discussed when we talked about finance. So the woman can still be at home and still offer value. It's all about giving value and looking beyond your immediate environment. It's all about looking at what you have and finding its relevance in today's context, not just within the four walls of your fence, your family, you and I, but, you know, reaching out to people out there who will definitely need you. Praise God. So today, let's go quickly into day 23. And today's title is Help. I'm going to read very quickly. Kennedy Chams, thank you for joining. I see Miss Ida. Quite a number of people. Thank you very much for joining. Let's quickly run today before the sun goes out. The sun goes back. Okay. Isaiah 41 verse 8 to 10 in the Message translation. But you, brethren, are my servant. You are Jacob, my first choice, descendants of my good friend Abraham. I pulled you in from all over the world, called you in from every dark corner of the earth, telling you, you are my servant, serving on my side. I have picked you. I haven't dropped you. Don't panic. I am with you. There is no need to fear, for I am your God. I'll give you strength. I'll help you. I'll hold you steady. Keep a firm grip on you. Let me read the latter part. I've picked you. I haven't dropped you. Don't panic. I am with you. There's no need to fear, for I am your God. I'll give you strength. I'll help you. I'll hold you steady. Keep a firm grip on you. Praise God. Now let's quickly go through the exposition. Everyone needs help. I know your wife was created to be your helper, but newsflash, she too needs help. And yes, she needs help from you, but she also needs help in areas you cannot provide help. So what do? You hand her over to the one who can help her. God's promise is that he will be with her. He will give her strength. And more importantly, that he will help her. Pray that your wife will never lack the help that she needs, whether physical, emotional, or physical, and that she will be marvelously helped by God. She will receive this help from men sent by God, from angels assigned to her, and from God himself. Interestingly, sometimes she may not even know that what she needs is help. And maybe you have watched her struggle unnecessarily, especially if you are married to a hardworking woman with a knack for martyrdom. Let me tell you, you need to insist that she gets help and that she will recognize and accept the help when it comes, when it does come and when it is offered. I know this is hard for you to understand because you are not averse to getting help, but sometimes some women struggle with it. The easiest way to ensure she gets help and it doesn't become a fight is to address it in prayer. Address it in prayer. Debbie Nice, it's good to see you. New York City. Are you joining from New York? Let me know. All right. So today's topic is quite interesting. Very interesting, I must say. And I want you to know that if you're watching this for the first time, we've talked about the woman as helper many times in this book. And I naturally would say that as much as the woman is the helper, she also needs to be helped. That God will be our help. When I'm praying, when I'm declaring, I talk about the fact that I am the helper to my husband. I make my home. But in doing all of these things, I do not diminish. I do not deplete because God is sending me help. And that God is even enabling my husband to see the areas where I need help also. So I'm super excited that this same thing is coming up today. And it is coming up as a whole topic, like a whole full topic. So Pastor Kingsley says here that you need to know that your wife needs help. And also, she will receive this help from, okay. And also, you ought to, the husband ought to identify the areas where the wife needs help. Okay, let's just read the worksheet. It says, what activities has your wife gotten involved in that have caused her to burn out? How can you step in and ensure it does not reoccur? What will make her life easier? Is it a piece of equipment? When will you get it for her? So the husband needs to be able to identify the areas where the wife needs help. I like what he said in the last paragraph about women who have the tendencies of martyrdom, because some women can be so hardworking, like workaholics. They want to juggle everything together. Remember, we talked about multitasking in one of the previous days. They want to multitask. They want to juggle everything together. But it is not just because they want to do it for everybody, but also because they have this sense of, let me do it, so that they see that I'm doing it. And peradventure, I died doing it. I would have died a worthy death. I would have died for a worthy cause. Do you understand? There are women like that. Not necessarily doing it for themselves. Not necessarily doing it for other people. But just doing it so that they get that feeling of gratification. That, oh, I am the one who did it. And I'm the one who killed myself. And I died while doing it. They will be happy to die while doing it. That's why he said, a woman who has a knack for martyrdom. If you find yourself with that kind of woman, you will need to pray that God himself will show you how to offer help, and God will create in her the ability to receive help, because such people find it very difficult to receive help. Such people find it very difficult to receive help. Praise God. All right. So today we're going to pray, but let me quickly pin the topic for today, which we're talking about. Today's topic is help. I need to pin it for those who are just joining us. Praise God. Okay, that's pinned. Let's move on. The prayer for today, number one, pray that your wife will never lack the help that she needs, whether physical, emotional, or spiritual, that she will always be marvelously helped by God, and it will come on time. Praise God. One of our further reading scripture is found in Psalm 46, verse 5. And it says, God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her at that right early. So there is such a thing as receiving help. There is such a thing as receiving help on time. There is such a thing as receiving help. There is such a thing as receiving help when you need it the most. Praise God. Right at the nick of time, when you feel unwilling, unable, that is the time that you need help the most. And may it come to you in the name of Jesus. So if you're a single lady as well here, don't stress yourself in marriage. Let's tackle it here and now. Let's begin to pray about it, that God will send us all of the help that we need. We do not lack help in any area, physically, mentally, spiritually, emotionally, in the name of Jesus Christ. I will not suffer for the things that have simple solutions around me. In the name of Jesus, things that can be solved by a word of advice from someone, things that can be solved by a simple question and answer somewhere. Lord, I will not suffer emotional breakdown. I will not be a wreck right in the middle of help. In the name of Jesus Christ, as I prepare myself, oh God, for this marriage, even while I am still waiting, Lord, help me to understand the things that I need. Open up the channels of my spirit to identify these things that I need, and give me, oh God, the enablement, the discernment, the instructions, oh God, that will move me in the right path, that I will encounter this help in the name of Jesus Christ. I will not be helpless. I am not helpless. And as I enter into marriage, I refuse to be helpless in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Praise God. The second part says that pray that because God is in the midst of her, she will not be moved. Hallelujah. But it's by situation or unforeseen events when they arise. She will set her face like a flint, knowing she can never be disgraced. I set my face like a flint. I know I can never be disgraced. God is in the midst of me. I cannot be moved. God shall help me at that right early. I cannot be moved by negative situations. I cannot be moved by negative unforeseen circumstances. There is a God who is at work in me. There is a God who is at work for me. There is a God who is on my side. Makayeda bashande galata. Remember what Pastor Kingsley says here. He says that pray that she receives help from men sent by God, from angels assigned to her, and from God himself. This is your prayer this afternoon, that you receive help from men sent by God. You receive help from angels assigned to you, and you receive help from God himself in the name of Jesus Christ. I am not destitute of help. I am not destitute of support. I am not destitute of assistance in the name of Jesus Christ. God is in the midst of me. God is in the midst of Tosin Babalola. She shall not be moved. God shall help her. God helps her at that right early, at the nick of time, at the nick of negative situations. In the name of Jesus Christ, I am helped. I am helped. I am helped. I am helped. I am helped by God. I am helped by God. I am helped by God. Physically, I am helped by God. Mentally, I am helped by God. Emotionally, I am helped by God. Psychologically, I am helped by God. Spiritually, I am helped by God. For me to function well, effectively as helper to my husband, I decree and I declare that even now, I am helped by God in Jesus' name. Amen. Number three, pray that she will not be afraid of people's opinion, but will be confident in the truth that God will never leave her nor forsake her, and neither will she see shame all the days of her life. Praise God. I am confident of who I am. Praise the Lord. I'm not afraid of people's opinion. I'm not afraid of people's sentiments. I'm not afraid of people's judgments. I am confident in who I am and what God has made me. In one of the days past, we talked about, under the topic, she shall prophesy. We talked about the need for the man. The need for the man to affirm the woman in her gifts so that she can express herself better in that gift, right? So this also goes without saying that the man must always do anything and everything possible to boost the confidence of the woman. Women are different. Some people just go ahead and do what they need to do. They don't necessarily need your veto, right? You know, to give them the confidence to do what they need to do. Some women will need that push, they want it to come by your words of affirmation. Some women keep affirming. They will still not make progress. They will still not do what they need to do. But you need to still keep affirming, because that is what they need. No matter what, that is what they need. If you do not affirm, they will be worse off. Even though it looks like they're not making progress, you take away that affirmation, you will see that they will be worse off, right? So that affirmation is it for some people. For some others, I can do without it. Hello, can we move on to something else? Okay, but regardless, even those who say they can do without it still need it. They still need it. So that is important. And here Pastor Kingsley is saying, pray for your wife that she will not be afraid of people's opinion about her. She will not be, because that thing can rob a woman of her destiny. It can literally strip her of her of fulfilling her assignment. And where she is not fulfilling her assignment, there is no sense of fulfillment generally in life. The sense of worth would deplete, sense of value would deplete, everything will be affected. How can such a woman even be of help to you? So single ladies, remember, we're like Esther. We're praying all of myrrh and sweet perfumes. We're taking these prayers and rubbing it on ourselves to prepare ourselves for marriage. All right. So I want you to pray today that you do not lack confidence. Many people are going to be feeding off your confidence, feeding off your courage to accomplish the will of God for your life. So you need it in large doses. So he says that you're not afraid of people's opinions. You're confident in the truth that God will never leave you nor forsake you. Neither will you be put to shame. Neither will you be put to shame all the days of your life. Lord, in the name of Jesus, today I pray that I will not be put to shame all the days of my life. I am confident in the truth of your word that says you will never leave me nor forsake me. It says so that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper. I will not fear. What can man do unto to me? It's in our further reading, Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 6. It says that the bed undefiled. And then he went on to say, the port of call is so that we may boldly say, I will not fear. What can man do unto me? As a single lady, you need to practice saying this. God will bring you into situations and circumstances. I'm not isolating myself. that situations and circumstances that will compel you to exercise your faith in this word that God says he will never leave me, he will never forsake me, that I may boldly say, what can man do unto me? Father, in the name of Jesus, today we receive your grace to pull through tough situations and circumstances of our lives. We receive, oh God, the grace that will uphold us and keep us strong, firmly gripped by you, oh God, and help us to be conscious of this at all times. Help us to be conscious of this at all times. Help us to be conscious of this at all times, regardless of what people say, regardless of what people think, regardless of their opinion and their beliefs about us. Oh God, help us to constantly walk in the consciousness of the fact and the truth that you, oh God, are with us, never to leave us, never to forsake us. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. The last prayer point, not the least, it says, pray that she recognizes help when it comes and that she will be willing to accept it. Amen. Some of us may be guilty of this. We just can't delegate. We just can't assign roles to other people. Why? Because we have some sort of, you know, tendencies that want things to go a certain way. And because maybe from experience we've assigned before, we've given to people, they couldn't think like us. They couldn't achieve the kind of result we wanted them to achieve. I noticed that it's even tougher for women who are able to communicate what they want clearly. And they have done everything to communicate it clearly. Oh, I'm not talking about ambiguous words and ambiguous statements. I'm talking about you teach this person A, B, C. This is how it should be done. But yet they still don't get it right. The next time you want to do it, you become jittery, afraid. You don't know if, you know, the person you're about to teach is about to waste your effort as well. So it takes a lot to accept help when it comes. Workaholic women, perfectionist women, I can do all by myself women. This is your point. As a single lady, using this oil of myrrh and sweet perfumes to prepare yourself for marriage like Esther, you need to learn how to receive help. So therefore, in the name of Jesus, Baba, I lift myself to you. I lift my life to you. I lift my life to you. I lift all of me to you. I ask, oh God, that you teach me how to trust again, how to believe again, how to assign roles, tasks, and responsibilities again, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, make me a better person at delegation. Make me a better person at discernment, to know who to assign what to at what time, in the name of Jesus Christ. I am not destitute of assistance, of support, and because I'm not destitute of it, when it comes, I identify it, I discern it, I pick it, I recognize it in the name of Jesus, and I appropriate it the way you want it to be appropriated, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Thank you so much for joining this afternoon. It's been a wonderful one, a wonderful, wonderful session. I wrote down one special prayer point or two. You see this one? It will sound funny, but please pray it. Pastor Kingsley said, newsflash, she also needs help, which means that some men are totally oblivious of the fact that the woman living with them, cooking for them, making everything work in the home as the homemaker, that woman also needs help. Some men don't know. Just because the Bible has already said God has brought Eve to Adam as help meet for him, does not mean that Eve also shouldn't be helped. Praise God. So I said, Lord, please let it not be news to my husband that I need help. Also, you know, I'm supposed to be praying for myself, but hello, I'm trying to safeguard my marriage. So please pray that it will not be news to your husband that you need help. God will begin to prepare him as well, just like you are being prepared right now, in the name of Jesus. Father, begin to nudge my husband. Let him know. Prompt him, oh God. The heart of a king is in the hand of the Lord. He turns it wheresoever he wills. Let him know. Bring him to the company of those who will enlighten him and educate him. Amen. The prayers for husbands can be funny. I think that's why I sort of find it easy to do the reverse engineering, because by the time I start to pray for a man who I have not met, you will start to say that I'm manipulative. So it's better I prepare myself and trust God to do a work in him, right? So, Lord, we're asking as single women, let our husbands know that we also need help. Prepare them now, oh God, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you all so much for joining. I thought we'd be able to take day 24. But with this heat, I don't think so. The heat is a lot. I don't think we'll be able to. So tomorrow, I'll be back, most likely in the morning. Tomorrow is Saturday, most likely in the morning. Yes, in the morning. I miss my early morning crew, honestly. Debbie Rose, Olani Jesus, Toby Sam, Kells. I miss my early morning gang. So tomorrow I'm going to be back here early, bright and early, and we're going to pray. So thank you so much for joining today. I'm not even sure we'll be able to take Job chapter 29, but I want us to take it regardless. The sun, the heat has already started. Let me just, Hallelujah. Ikale de basundre de boshantaya. Likateye de dosevrige de vesuntia lakim. Librada koshende viria kwaparata lingde. Redoka palia doshende varada baba baba santi. Rige de kubarande gezeshendre di balatim. Wira, thank you for joining. Nana, where have you been? Good to see you. Thank you for joining. Le karande shubra da kasita liada baka indaba. Rede bosu brega di galasinti de bosha. Radua televeru asaka niana mama mama kisha. Rede bosu pradi katiende veriasha. Le do kuria saka taya da baba baba. Jele de barasketi de. I'm trying to bring up Job 29. Okay, we are here now. Remember how we read it. Grab your Bibles if you can. Let's quickly do this together. Moreover, I, Chosen Babalala, continue my parable and I say, I am in the months and in the days that God preserves me. By his candle shines upon my head, and by his light I walk through darkness. I am in the days of my youth. The secret of God is upon my tabernacle. The Almighty is with me. My children are about me. I wash my steps with butter. The rock pours me out rivers of oil. I go out to the gates through the city. I prepare my seat in the street. The young men see me and hide themselves. The aged arise and stand up. The princes refrain talking and lay their hands upon their mouth. The nobles hold their peace and their tongue cleaves to the roof of their mouth. When the ear hears me, it blesses me. When the eye sees me, it gives witness to me, because I delivered the poor who cried and the fatherless, and him that had none to help him. The blessing of him that was ready to perish comes upon me. I cause the widow's heart to sing for joy. My judgment is as a robe and a diadem. I am eyes to the blind. I am feet to the lame. I am father to the poor, and the cause which I knew not I searched out. I break the jaws of the wicked, and I pluck the spoil out of his teeth. Then I say, I shall die in my nest. I shall multiply my days as the sand and the phoenix. My root is spread out by the waters, and the dew lay all night upon my branch. Praise the Lord. My glory is fresh in me, and my bow is renewed in my hand. Unto me men give ear, and they wait, and they keep silent at my counsel. Praise God. After my words they speak not again, and my speech drops upon them, and they wait for me as for the latter rain. They opened their mouth wide as for the latter rain. If I laugh on them, they believed it not. And the light of my countenance they cast not down. I choose out their way. I sit as chief. I dwell as king in the army, as one who comforts mourners. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. My friend is in the building. Oida Molade Bowale. I see all your videos and your pictures from the school tour, the school outreach tour. Well done. Okay, so that is it from me tonight. You have heard Job chapter 29. That's our confession. And amen. Nana, thank you. Praise the Lord. We are closing now. Invite somebody. Let them join. If you're watching this on YouTube, please do well to subscribe before you leave. Click on that like button. Click on the subscribe button as well. And above all, please tap on that notification button so that you can get a prompt whenever I upload a new video that I'm sure you are going to like. Until I come your way tomorrow, remember, it's early in the morning. Do stay safe, stay sane, and have a wonderful time. God bless you, and bye-bye. And make our hearts your home. These hearts, these minds, these words, this world, and everywhere we go, and every day there, Lord, I pray you make our hearts your home. Yeah.